No, well, he's absolutely correct. He was saying that sometimes you can do all the right things. You know, you could maybe say the right things, maybe, you know, ask the officer, you know, why am I being stopped and all of that, and you can still end up in a bad situation, like he described Trayvon Martin, who was shot and killed, and another kid in Philly who's been shot. And so, you know, what I'll say about that is that that's a reality that for a long time in this country, you know, people of color, when they're dealing with the police, they view us as more dangerous. Whether, you know, based on their own fear, based on lack of knowledge of the community or whatever, you know, a lot of times they claim it's fear. I'll put it like this, they claim that it's fear. And so we've seen so many examples in the last few years of people who are really not a threat to the cops. You know, there was a guy in Oklahoma who had his hands up, you know, and just turned towards the car and they just shot, you know. And a lot of times those cops will lose their jobs, maybe after a whole lot of public outcry or if there's a trial. But in many of those cases, those cops are allowed to continue working because, you know, if the cop gave the person a specific order to do something and the person didn't do it, you know, the courts will sometimes find that the cop was okay. You know, like let's say the cop says, hey, turn around right now. And you don't turn around right there. You just ask them a question, yo, why do I turn around? You know, and the cop ends up shooting you. A lot of times the courts will find that the cop is in the right. You know, even if everybody else sees it as wrong. You know, like, I don't even like to keep bringing up those stories because they're traumatizing for us to keep seeing, but everybody knows that Eric Garner didn't deserve what happened to him. You know, most people can see that and see that it was not right. But there's a power structure that keeps police in place, that keeps them allowing them to come back and doing those things. So in answer to your question, basically, what he was saying is, what if you're doing the right thing and the wrong thing can still happen? You have to, at all times, even not just with police, you know, even when you're just walking down the street and anybody comes up to you and starts talking to you or you know, involving themselves with you, you always got to be careful, right? Any type of interaction you have. And the power that you have in every situation is knowing what you're going to say and how you're going to handle that situation. So if a person comes up to you and is like, yo, what's up, man? I want to talk to you. You know, you can say, hey, I'm good. You know, I don't mind having a conversation with you for a minute. But at a certain point, you have the power to remove yourself from that situation. And what I'm saying here is that the police might look at you and say, you know what? I think he's a drug dealer. I think he's in a gang or I think he's got something on him. But you have the power to ask that cop, you know what, am I being stopped for a reason or am I free to go? And that police officer has been trained to have to answer that question, yes or no. He's got to say, yeah, you've got a right to walk down the street, or no, I'm stopping you. If he says, I'm stopping you, he's also got to identify why he's stopping you. And if he doesn't, you can say, you know, what am I being stopped for? Police have to, if they're going to detain you, like, okay, there's a difference between being detained, right, if you're like on the street and the cop says, hey, I just want you way over here. That's what's called being detained, right? This means for some period of time, they're basically just asking you to wait there while they figure out whatever's happening. This is actually the third level of police encounter, so we're kind of moving on. But a lot of times what happens is a fight happens, right? Like, let's say, you know, five or six kids get in a fight, somebody on the block calls the police, oh my God, these kids are fighting, you know? And then